Hello, my name is Sarah Zika. I'm an electrical engineer for Team Master Hackers of the Padlock Solver.
The scope of the Padlock Solver is it needs to be a device used to manipulate a secured padlock to obtain the combination. The objectives of this project are to efficiently solve a padlock and display the combination while being aesthetically pleasing, as well as being safe and user-friendly. It must be lightweight, portable, and standalone, as well as robust, and we must provide documentation. The motivation for doing this project is it can be used for customers who have forgotten combinations to their locks.
Now I'll be giving you a demonstration of our working product.
Hi, my name is Matt Levis, and I'm an electrical engineer on the Master Hackers team. This is our padlock solver, and I'll be demoing how it works today. I'll be using this padlock right here with an unknown combination, along with this instruction card that tells me how to use the device. The first step is to plug the device into a wall outlet. The next step is to turn the power switch on and open the lid. As you can see right here, we have a switch that lets us know if the door is open or closed. Right now it's in a state where the door is open so that the device cannot start and cannot hurt the user. The next step is to manually rotate the dial of the lock to zero. As you can see, it's at zero. Next, place the secured padlock with the dial side down into the lock cradle. The next step is to ensure that the lock is properly seated and clamp it shut. So I make sure that it's in, and then I close the clasp. Now it's shut. Next, I'll use the mirror along with the green and yellow buttons to make sure that it's at zero. So right now I can see the dial of the lock, and each button turns it in a different direction. I'll press the buttons until it lines up exactly on zero. Now we've made 100% sure that the lock is on zero. Next step is to close the lid. At this point, the switch has been shut, so now the machine knows that the lid is closed and it's protecting the user. Next, I'll press the green start button. As you can see, we have our process right here. We've turned the power on, we've found the third number, and we're trying different combinations. Right up here, the screen tells you how many combinations we've tried so far. Down here, we have our start button. This is our cancel button. If you press the cancel button, the process will end up canceling itself, and a red LED will pop on right here. This is our mute button, and what happens is at the end of the device, it will, when it solves the lock, it'll play music, and you can either choose to have the sound on or sound off. This is our power button. On the side here, you can see this is our speaker that's used to play the music. This is our motor driver, and behind it, you can see the microcontroller. Right here, you have the motor, and what it's doing is it's turning the dial of the lock when it's trying the different combinations. On the side here, you have the solenoid, and as you can see, every time that it pulls, it's trying a different combination. In the back, we have our warning labels. And finally, now, you can see that the lock's been solved by the music, and it also tells you what the combination is. Right here, we have an LED that says that the combination's found. Next, I'll be opening the lid, and I'll open up the clamp. And as you can see, the lock has been solved. In order to make sure that this combination is correct, I will show you that it works. First number is 12. Second number is 2. And the third number is 8.
Thank you, Matt. As you saw, we were successfully able to open a secured padlock, as well as receive the combination for that lock. We were able to meet our customer-described goals and our objectives for this device. Thank you.